A couple of weeks ago, my family experienced our first Florida hurricane. It was all kinds of bad for so many people. But one of the things I love about my wife is that she loves storms as much as I do. Ever since we started dating, we've been somewhat of like amateur storm chasers. We would drive down to the ocean and watch the lightning or just listen to the rain. And when I was in high school, the local paper even managed to snap a picture of me jumping off the town boardwalk in the middle of a tropical storm. And even at the start of this Hurricane Sally, we were out walking the neighborhood, fighting the wind and playing in the puddles and just having a good time. But as the storm began to build overnight, that sense of thrill and wonder began to fade into a blend of anxiousness and aggravation. Because even though this wasn't our first hurricane, it was our first one in a home that we owned. And as we sat and watched shingles torn from our roof and trees falling and fences mangled, we, like so many of you, felt helpless. And in the aftermath of the storm, we saw everything from flooded buildings and homes and rogue barges, displaced families, and so many affected local businesses. It's been a sobering reminder of how little control we actually have. And as it says in 1 Timothy 6, we brought nothing into this world and we can take nothing with us when we leave. So even though we might not be able to control what happens to us in this life, we can control how we respond to it, and how we respond to what happens can have an eternal effect on the world around us. Paul goes on in his letter to Timothy to say in chapter 6, verse 17, "Teach those who are rich in this world not to be proud and not to trust in their money, which is unreliable. Their trust should be in God, who richly gives us all we need for our enjoyment. Tell them to use their money to do good. They should be rich in good works and generous to those in need, always being ready to share with others. By doing this, they will be storing up their treasures as a good foundation for the future so that they may experience true life." So how are you responding? The hurricane might be over, but for so many, the storm has just begun. How will we respond to it? Will we be just observers watching in wonder from a place of safety and comfort as others struggle around us? Or are we going to be obedient to the Lord and look for ways to bless those in need, to share what we can with those who are hurting, to support the ones who may not be able to support themselves right now? How we respond is not just about being financially supportive, which is great if you can be that, but it's not what it's all about. It's about spreading the love of God to our community in so many different ways. We don't help others to make ourselves feel good. We feel good because we are being obedient to His word by pointing others to Christ with love and action.